Hello from the Cannes Film Festival, and we're starting with one of French literature's biggest classics, The Count of Monte Cristo, which is getting the big screen treatment here in Cannes. The adventure novel, written by French author Alexandre Dumas in 1844, is one of the author's most popular works, along with The Three Musketeers. The actor Pierre Niney, famous for his role in Yves Saint Laurent, plays Edmond Dantès, the tragic hero transformed into the powerful Count of Monte Cristo. France 24's Louise Dupont has been to meet him.
Je porte ici un mandat d'arrêt pour le dénommé Edmond Dantès.
Si Dantès nous a trahis, alors qu'il est le sort des traîtres.
Je suis innocent! J'ai rien fait, je suis innocent!
Il vivra. Et pour tout le monde, il sera mort.
It's the first book that made me travel so much. It felt like my bedroom was moving. I didn't know where I was. I'd turn the light back on at night and I'd say to myself, just one more chapter. This thirst for revenge, justice, desire to replace God himself and become the richest man in the world. It makes you wonder, where does justice stop? When does one become a monster?
Je suis l'abbé Faria. Et moi, je te porte le plus grand trésor que la terre ait jamais porté. Et je sais où se trouve le trésor.
Mais que feras-tu de cette fortune? Feras-tu le bien ou laisseras-tu ton cœur s'emplir de haine?
I think it's the first time you play in a cloak and dagger film. Did you like it?
Quel plaisir vous avez pris justement à cet exercice-là?
I love En Garde with Daniel Auteuil, who's actually in Cannes right now. I also love Cyrano de Bergerac. So I enjoyed rediscovering sword duels, horse races. There were other physical challenges as well, so it was like being a kid again. But there was also the desire of putting on a great show for people. I loved it. I loved that challenge.
You're a regular on the Croisette. Why do you like coming here so much?
Well, it's the biggest festival in the world. All my idols and the people whose work I'm passionate about have been here or are currently here. I was at a dinner the other day and Julianne Moore was there. I was like crazy. I love that actress. I'm amazed every day by the actors I get to meet, the directors, but also the daring producers like the one behind The Count of Monte Cristo.
Je renonce à la seule force qui me tient en vie.
So The Count of Monte Cristo is one of several French films showing at this year's Cannes Film Festival, from a body horror with Demi Moore to a gritty social drama about a young French woman dreaming of becoming a famous influencer. There are rich pickings from French filmmakers. My favourite is probably The Substance, which is all about the pressure on women to defy ageing in today's world. Olivia Salazar-Winspear tells us more now about the French offerings competing for the big prize, the Palme d'Or.
A Mexican cartel boss, a disillusioned lawyer, and some musical numbers along the way. Jacques Audiard's film, Emilia Perez, has been a word-of-mouth hit on the Riviera this year. The buzz around the movie has even seen it tipped for the top prize. Meanwhile, feminist body horror The Substance has also won Coralie Farjat critical acclaim. With Demi Moore, Margaret Qualley and Dennis Quaid in leading roles, it's the French filmmaker's Cannes debut.
A better version of yourself. Younger, more beautiful, more perfect. One single.
It follows an aging actress played by Demi Moore, clinging desperately to her youth.
This was about the male perspective of the idealized woman that we have bought into.
Another French film in the running for the top prize, Agathe Heidinger's first feature, Wild Diamond. It tells a story of the teenage influencer who agrees to appear in a popular reality TV show.
I've always watched reality TV. I was appalled by these new stories, this new mythology that was being broadcast on television, on the internet, on social networks, and which highlighted some very extreme values, since reality TV is based on class contempt, hyper-sexualizing women to create entertainment.
The latest offering from veteran director Christophe Honoré is a meta-comedy, Marcello Mio. It follows Chiara Mastroianni as she adopts the persona of her late father, Marcello Mastroianni.
J'ai encore rêvé de mon père cette nuit. C'est comme s'il me hantait. Enfin non, plutôt c'est comme si c'était moi qui étais devenu le fantôme de mon père.
Il te manque, c'est tout.
The actress explores the complex reality of being the daughter of two cinema icons, starring alongside her mother, Catherine Deneuve.
To be honest, playing my own role is not the most appealing. But I read the script and I really liked it. I thought it had a lot of spirit, a lot of originality, a lot of tenderness. I thought it was very original.
As for Michel Hazanavicius, he went for animation in his adaptation of best-selling novel The Most Precious of Cargoes. And it's a love story from Gilles Lelouch, starring screen favourites François Civil and Adèle Exarchopoulos as an unlikely couple in Beating Hearts. Six French films fending off stiff competition for the coveted Palme d'Or.
At this point, we've seen a lot of movies in Cannes. I've watched more than 20. Our team has been asking people about their favourites.
So my favourite film of the festival so far is or was The Substance by Coralie Fargin, simply because I'm a lover of genre cinema. I run a film festival for genre cinema in Vienna.
Have you ever dreamt of a better version of yourself?
The Apprentice. I love the way it was written. The dialogues are brilliant. They are like missiles, a bit like the character the film is about, Donald Trump.
I really liked it a lot, mainly because it shows another side of Donald Trump where you kind of show a little bit of sympathy for him, even though he's still Donald Trump and we don't support or like him.
My favorite film, O Canada. My favorite actor, Richard Gere. That's one of the best performers nowadays in Hollywood.
Amanda was a jazz pianist.
The film I like best is Parthenope. I loved its aesthetics. I found the characters very touching.
Usually not a huge fan of Sorrentino, but this time I thought he did a great job, visually especially. It's very, very intense and very felt film.
Limonov, the ballad. I love the aesthetics, the storyline, the way it's constructed.
The Shrouds. I want to believe in that film and what it could have been. So I'd say it's my favorite, although I found it a bit too long.
Maybe not meant for the dead either. Maybe a big mistake.
Sometimes it's not about good films, sometimes it's about great films that stick with you.
Next, he's the creator of one of the most iconic film franchises in history. Star Wars inventor George Lucas will receive a Lifetime Achievement Award at the closing ceremony of this year's Cannes Film Festival. Olivia Salazar-Winspear looks back at his life and career.
It's a familiar refrain for these film fans. George Lucas is a favourite here at the Cannes Film Festival. His first visit was in 1971 for his debut feature, THX-1138. More than 50 years later, he's being celebrated for his body of work with an honorary Palme d'Or.
He's one of the great directors that we have from this era. He revolutionized cinema with Star Wars.
It's amazing because George Lucas has had such an impact on Hollywood and cinema and everything. And he's only directed six movies. Everything else, he's kind of been a producer, mastermind kind of.
I'm real happy he has the honor of being here at Cannes the same year we are. And, you know, I really hope he enjoys the award. It's well deserved after years of great service to cinema.
Here they come.
After the phenomenal success of Star Wars in 1977, Lucas suggested another project to actor Harrison Ford, this time playing an adventurous archaeologist named Indiana Jones.
Doing it more than anything else so that I can enjoy it. Because I just want to see this movie.
Now, can I start the run?
The first installment was directed by Steven Spielberg and gave rise to four sequels. Something of a pioneer, in 1975, George Lucas developed his own special effects studio, ILM, to achieve some of the iconic visual sequences in the first Star Wars film. It won them eight Academy Awards. His production company, Lucasfilm, was a major player in Hollywood.
Sometimes people bring things that they don't know how to do. And we just say, you know, this is impossible, it can't be done. And usually it can't be, because if ILM can't do it, I don't think anybody can do it.
The new Star Wars prequels and sequels like 2015's The Force Awakens saw a new generation of fans enthralled by the cosmic saga. The last three films brought in more than $1 billion each. 3 years earlier, George Lucas had signed over the rights to Disney, but he'll always be the creator of cinema's most iconic intergalactic adventure.
Nothing will stand in our way.
We'll leave you now with a biopic about the star of iconic and controversial 1972 movie Last Tango in Paris, in Being Maria. Anna Maria Bartolome plays the French actress Maria Schneider alongside Matt Dillon as Marlon Brando. Thanks for your company. See you tomorrow for our penultimate show from the Cannes Film Festival.
Vous avez quel âge, Maria?
19.
En lisant, vous avez dû voir que vous y étiez souvent nu. Ça vous dérange?
Non. Enfin, ça dépend comment. C'est surtout les scènes d'amour. Qu'est-ce qu'il faudra faire?
Comme dans la vie. Je plaisante. Vous en faites pas. On filmera ça le plus artistiquement possible.